सरफेस एरिया ऑफ यूरेनियम न्यूक्लियाई 15, रेट ऑफ प्रोडक्शन ऑफ न्यूट्रॉन्स इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू नंबर ऑफ न्यूक्लियाई प्रेजेंट इन यूरेनियम मॉलिक्यूल, दैट इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू आर क्यूब. रेट ऑफ लीकेज ऑफ न्यूट्रॉन्स इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू सरफेस एरिया ऑफ यूरेनियम न्यूक्लियाई, दैट इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू आर स्क्वायर. 16, रेशियो ऑफ रेट ऑफ लीकेज ऑफ न्यूट्रॉन्स टू द रेट ऑफ प्रोडक्शन ऑफ न्यूट्रॉन्स प्रोपोर्शनल टू 1/r. नाउ लेट्स सी चेन रिएक्शन अंडर फेवरेबल कंडीशंस. द न्यूट्रॉन प्रोड्यूस्ड आउट ऑफ फिशन ऑफ यूरेनियम 235, अगेन फिशन अदर यूरेनियम न्यूक्लियाई in the same way and form a chain which continues until the whole of the uranium is consumed is called chain reaction. Necessary conditions for chain reaction: first, the size of the fissionable material must be greater than the critical size. What is critical size? The minimum size mass of the fissionable material which is necessary for chain reaction is known as critical size or critical mass. For uranium, the critical size is nearly 10 kg. Second, out of the neutrons obtained from fission, at least one neutron must be available for further fission. Type of chain reactions: there are two type of chain reaction. First is controlled chain reaction, second is uncontrolled chain reaction. Let's see first controlled chain reaction. Nuclear reaction in which through artificial means rate of fission is kept constant and only one neutron is able to fission another uranium nuclei in succeeding chain link is called controlled chain reaction. This goes slowly and here neutron reproduction factor is 1. This reaction takes place in atomic, that is nuclear reactor. Second, uncontrolled chain reaction. Nuclear reaction in which rate of fission is not constant and more than one neutron takes part in the fission of remaining nuclei, and so reaction gets very fast and whole of the uranium gets consumed in a fraction of time and there remains no control on the reaction is called uncontrolled chain reaction. Here K, that is neutron reproduction factor, is more than 1. Energy produced from this is used for destructive purpose. Atom bomb is based on this principle. Atom bomb or nuclear bomb is based on the principle of uncontrolled chain reaction. Now let's see neutron reproduction factor K. K equal to rate of production of neutrons divided by rate of loss of neutrons, or K equal to rate of production of neutrons in a certain generation divided by rate of production of neutrons in the previous generation. K equal to number of neutron produced divided by neutron absorbed plus neutron leakage. If K equal to 1, then the self-sustained chain reaction will be controlled. The mass of fissionable material at this stage is known as critical mass. B, if K less than 1, then chain reaction is not possible and the mass of fissionable material is known as subcritical mass. See, if K more than 1, then the chain reaction will be uncontrolled and the mass of fissionable material is known as supercritical mass. Let's see the example of controlled chain reaction, that is nuclear reactor. Figure shows the nuclear reactor, the device in which energy is generated by controlled chain reaction of nuclear fission is known as nuclear reactor. Here moderator and control rods are used, the type of nuclear reactor. Nuclear reactors are of two types. A homogeneous nuclear reactor, the nuclear reactor in which the fuel and the moderator are mixed uniformly is known as homogeneous nuclear reactor. B inhomogeneous nuclear reactor, the nuclear reactor in which the fuel and the moderator are separate is known as inhomogeneous nuclear reactor. C main parts of nuclear reactor: first fuel, second moderator, third coolant, fourth control rods, fifth protective shields. First fuel, the fissionable material is known as fuel. For example, 92 uranium-235, 94 plutonium-239, 90 thorium-232, etc. Second moderator, the materials used to slow down the speed of the neutrons without their absorption are known as moderators. For example, graphite, heavy water, paraffin wax, beryllium oxide, etc. Characteristics of moderator: first, its atomic weight must be low. Second, it should not absorb neutrons. Third, it should collide elastically with neutrons and reduce their velocity.